A massive lifeline tonight for tenants and landlords in New South Wales with a $440 million rescue package announced by the state government. The six-month safety net is aimed at keeping renters in their properties, but there are concerns it simply won't help enough people.
As the jobs dried up, the ability of tenants to pay rent went with them. Renters and their landlords have been crying out for help. Today, the state government stepped in.
Protecting tenants from being evicted. It protects landlords from tenants in circumstances where payment of rent is not being paid.
$440 million will be split evenly between residential and commercial tenancies. In the package, an immediate 60-day stop on all applications already underway to evict tenants financially affected by COVID-19. And then for the next 6 months, a moratorium on evictions due to rental arrears. There's a 25% rebate or waiver of land tax for landlords who pass on an equivalent saving to their tenant. Land tax will also be deferred for 3 months for those eligible and yet to pay it. Both sides must also negotiate before a tenancy can be terminated.
If they cannot get to an agreed position, then the tenants and landlords will then go through to the tribunal, who will then make an order.
The Tenants Union of New South Wales gets $2.3 million for extra resources to deal with the flood of inquiries.
While we saw some positive results early on, really, for the last couple of weeks, it's been a very hard slog for many renters in New South Wales.
Tenants need to have lost at least 25% of their income to be eligible. The union believes there's still a question over what happens when landlords can't reduce rents for financial reasons.
A third of all properties in Sydney are rented, and it's telling that in the 3 weeks to April 5, the number of properties being listed for rent in Greater Sydney actually jumped by 18% on the previous year.
Given only 16% of landlords pay land tax, the opposition says more needs to be done.
So that leaves 84% of landlords who will receive no assistance at all.
And property investors agree.
We think it's going to kick in too early, and there's now going to be an expectation on landlords to be able to service this when, in effect, they're not actually getting much money back at all.
This is not a one-size-fits-all approach. It is very difficult to do that. This is an area with a lot of complexity, a lot of players at stake.
Eddie Meyer, Nine News.